Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. In this video, we're going to look at the memory items for an emergency descent as a result of a rapid decompressurization. This is an extremely serious event. It's life-threatening, and therefore, in order to avoid delay reaching safety, we commit some of those items to memory. Our time of useful consciousness at this altitude, which is currently 35,000 feet, is around 3 to 4 seconds. So we have to react very quickly, and the most important action on that list is to get our oxygen mask on. Before every flight, we must ensure that the oxygen supply is available and our mask fits properly with a good seal around the face, so we don't have to be having to deal with adjusting straps and so forth at this altitude. That is crucial. Any time spent in terms of seconds having to make those adjustments can lead to a life-threatening situation. That's really important to note. So our memory items for this event are as follows. So as we've mentioned already, crew oxygen masks on. That's the first and one of the most important actions. The cabin masks should automatically deploy. We then turn on the passenger seatbelt signs, and we begin an emergency descent by using the FCU, pulling the altitude knob, and selecting a lower altitude. That is usually flight level 100, but we have to consider terrain and what our minimum safe altitude in this area is. So that's something we're always discussing during the cruise as we're going about our day-to-day operations. If we are over high terrain, as part of our en route discussions and considerations, we would be considering our path to escape, which way we should turn to reach a lower altitude as quickly as possible. So we'd have that planned already. And quite possibly we would mark that onto our navigation displays using the MCDU. We'd also pull and turn on the heading knob, so we want at least a 20 degree variation left or right of track. Because we're going to be on a flight path, which is likely to be busy, there could be traffic underneath us. So we make a turn, and we also pull the speed knob there on the FCU as well. We then announce our FMAs to ensure that the actions we've just inputted into the FCU are what we'd expect. If we do not have the autothrottle active for any reason, we would idle the throttles, and we select full speed brake. Once we've established into a descent, we want to ensure that we're keeping the speed up just below the maximum speed allowable. That needs to be adjusted as we descend, because that will our maximum allowable speed will change. We then select the engine mode selector to ignition, and we would inform ATC, and we'd give them a message such as Mayday, 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 Easy 93 Charlie Echo, emergency descent, we've turned onto heading 300, descending expeditiously to flight level 100, standby for further intentions. We would then select the transponder to 7700 so air traffic control can identify us as an emergency aircraft. If we were at flight level 140 or 14,000 feet below, and but still above that sort of flight level 100 where there's still an oxygen risk, the mask won't deploy in that situation. So we can manually deploy the masks by pressing this switch here, which is the mask command on. So it's important to note that below 14,000 feet you won't get automatic deployment. So that's a consideration we have on the checklist. Those are the immediate actions. Let's run through that now. So we're cruising along 35,000 feet. Flight level 350. Decompressurization occurs. The first thing we do, we get that mask on before anything else, before even acknowledging the master caution. The oxygen mask must come on, and they're located down here. We can then select the seatbelts to on, and we're going to pull on the altitude knob here, and we're going to select flight level 100. We're going to pull and turn on the heading, take us off course, and we're going to pull speed as well. We announce our FMAs, thrust idle, open descent, heading. We've got auto thrust available, so we don't need to idle the throttles ourselves, and we select full speed brake. That's deployed. Engine mode selected to ignition. We're all the time adjusting the speed, so we're just below the red line. Inform ATC. Mayday, 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 easy 93 Charlie Echo, emergency descent, decompressurization. We're turning on to heading 300, descending to flight level 100. Standby for further intentions. We then enter 7700 into the transponder. That lets ATC know that we're an emergency aircraft. We're obviously considering our minimum safe altitude here. Flight level 100 is fine for us, but we want to turn terrain on and just have an awareness of what is beneath us terrain-wise. And obviously at this point, if we were below 14,000 feet, we would ensure that the masks were manually deployed. You can see here the passenger oxygen system is on and the masks have deployed. We're keeping that speed up. You can see here we do have actions here on the ECAM, but these are items that we conduct from memory. Once we're in a safe state and we're comfortable with the situation, we'd want to ensure we're updating the cabin crew of the situation and notifying them when a cabin oxygen is no longer required. We've got a rate of descent, it's increasing, approaching 6,000 feet per minute. This will be uncomfortable for the passengers. However, it's vital that we get down to that safe altitude for the safety of all on board. Once we've reached our safe altitude, we'd consider other checklists and make diversion considerations. Any questions on that? Please drop them in the comments. Please hit the like button if you found that video useful. Thanks for watching.